In this video, I'm going to show you how to change or update account settings in Hoopla. Most of the time when something goes wrong in Hoopla, it has to do with an outdated or incorrect account setting. So this video may help if you're having problems logging in or checking things out from Hoopla. So we've opened up the Hoopla app, and you're going to tap or click on the gear icon. Now I'm showing this to you on an iPhone. It may look slightly different depending on what type of phone or tablet you're using, or if you're on a computer, but the same basic principles apply. So now we have a settings menu. We see personal settings and library settings as the first two options. When you first set up an account with Hoopla, you enter your email address and choose a password, and these are your personal settings. This is helpful because if you log out of your Hoopla account or want to use Hoopla on a new device, you don't have to know your library card number or have it handy to log in. You just need to know your email address and the password you chose when you set up the account. It's important to know that your account in Hoopla is separate from your library account and can't be accessed by library staff. So if your email address changes, you'll need to log into Hoopla and update the email yourself, even if you've already updated it with the library. To do that, go to Personal Settings and type your new email address into the field. You'll notice that the password field looks blank. Hoopla does not show your password for security reasons, but a password is required, and you can change your password by typing a new one in this field. If you've forgotten your password and can't log into your Hoopla account, you'll need to contact Hoopla directly or ask library staff to contact Hoopla on your behalf to reset the password. In order to use Hoopla, you need to verify that you have a valid account with the Anchorage Public Library. So when you first set up Hoopla, you enter your library card number and the PIN that is associated with your library account, and this is stored in library settings. You should see your library card number here. If you lose your card and get a new number, you'll need to log into Hoopla and update your card information in this field. This information does not automatically update when we issue you a new card, and staff cannot access your Hoopla account. Just like with your password, the PIN for your library card is not shown even though it has been entered. Since the PIN is part of your library card account, staff can look this up for you if you've forgotten your PIN and can change it in your library account if you want a new PIN. But, just like with the other settings, if you change your PIN, you'll need to log in and update it here in Hoopla. PINs can include numbers, letters, and symbols. They are case sensitive, so make sure that you enter your PIN exactly as it is in your library account. And I just want to quickly show you what it looks like if you're using a computer and the internet instead of the Hoopla app. When you go to settings, you'll see this horizontal list. Library settings is here. And instead of personal settings, there are email and password tabs. So this is where you'll go if you need to change those settings. If you're having problems checking things out from Hoopla or getting error messages, make sure your library card number and PIN are correct. If you still get an error message, try re-entering your PIN. Even if you know you have the right PIN and it hasn't changed, sometimes re-entering it will fix the problem. If you're still having issues, contact the Anchorage Public Library. Staff will verify that your card hasn't expired or been blocked and help you contact Hoopla support if necessary.